Hey guys, and welcome to Nemetic Dmitry channel. So today we're talking about M1 Max once again. So it's been 4 months since I've started using the M1 platform, and I'm using the MacBook Air. And I should say that I really like it for the most part, but I actually accumulated a few things, few challenges that I just want to share with you about this platform. Not everything is super ideal, not everything is great, but just wanted to talk about it basically. So right here, right now, I'm using the Kali Linux in my Parallels environment. So I have Parallels right here, and I just have Ubuntu, Windows 10, and Kali installed right here. And I can actually just confirm it to you. So here it is. I'm just running the 64 platform, ARM. Here it is. By the way, I really like the shell on the Kali Linux. The shell on Kali Linux is really cool. Like by default, whatever they put here, really cool. And by the way, the Parallels right here, what I like about it actually is that I can just install it like this. I just press continue. I can just basically select download Kali Linux and it's gonna install it for me. It's gonna just like download the image and install it for me. So this is the part that I like about this environment. But Parallels is not ideal either, to be honest, guys. So this is what happens when you try, for example, to run the Ubuntu Linux. This is the kind of error I get. So basically that kind of challenges. Why? I don't know why. Because probably just had some preview kind of version of Parallels before, and then I upgraded to the full version, now have the license, but still some images just like didn't start like that. And I was able to fix it for Windows 10, for example. The thing is that I just like went directly to the package, like show in Finder. I just opened the package right here. And then I just basically need to go here to show package content. Then I need to modify the config file and basically modify the version to the latest one. Right now it's 16.5 something. So basically that's how I fix it for Windows 10, for example. So it's not ideal, and I see bugs there and there for Parallels as well. So it's not ideal in terms of running stuff. But it runs Kali, Debian, and Ubuntu pretty nicely. So I should say that it's still feasible. It's probably one of the best options that you have when it comes to running ARM versions of the systems, because guys, UTM, I was just struggling with UTM. The UTM is the main problem, is just it's not polished, it crashes all the time, and x86 emulation, guys, x86 emulation is just horrible. I don't know, it's just so slow, it's so bad. I just abandoned all the ideas about running something in the environment like that. So I was thinking about running the x86 version of Windows, and then I just tried it, and no, it doesn't make any sense. I don't like it. So the only option you have basically running the Windows 10 in Parallels or UTM, but again, UTM is just like Windows 10 basically is able to run your x86 32 or 64-bit applications. So it's basically okay, this part works, at least something works. But it's still a technical preview, so like so it's still not a finalized version and all that, so I don't know, probably more challenges coming our way. So that's not ideal. The second thing is the development on the M1 platform is also challenging, because guys, I should say that I was trying to run React Native here, and there was so many challenges. Like basically I had the project that I wanted to run on the system, and I was having challenges all the way. So it doesn't start, it doesn't like the architecture. You need to specify the specific architecture you want to compile in Xcode. And guys, there's additional challenge, because let me show it to you. In Xcode here, I specified to run it in Rosetta. So it should run in Rosetta. That's the only way I was able to run my React Native project here on Xcode. So it was challenging. I don't know why. There's some documentation there, and there are people on forums asking stuff, but I mean, it's all like really, really new and really experimental. So it's not really like a polished kind of platform for development. That's what I feel. Android Studio, guys, it's a mess. I saw other people on forums saying stuff that Android Studio doesn't work well. That's my experience as well. Like simulator was not starting. I think I tried it some time ago and it was not even like very slow or something like that. So maybe the only way you can run this on a device itself, so like you compile the APK and run this one on a device. That's what I wanted to say. And other challenge is that the sound doesn't really work on Linuxes. So this is the Parallels, and if you look here, it says like it's fine, it shows the all the audio devices I have here, but it's not working. It just doesn't really work. It's not. I don't know. I looked up the forums, and they say in the next release, right now, which release we have right now is the 16.5 release of Parallels. In version 17, I think it's actually fixed. So it's like that. It's a messy. Like sound is not working on Linux at all entirely. I was not able to run it, and just like really bad. But the system runs very smooth, very very nicely, and I don't see much problems. So applications open just fine. All the stuff you expect for the Kali Linux for Ubuntu is just working well. I think it's good in that sense. So you can actually use your Linux instances here, which is good. But there's a next problem. For example, you want to run something in Docker, right? But there are some challenges that when it comes to running some stuff, for example, in Docker, right? Because you need to remind yourself to actually specify that platform is ARM64 and not all the images are running in 64. For example, this is the HTTPD and this Docker image works just fine on ARM64 platform, which we can see right here. So when you're trying to pull the image from a Docker repository, it doesn't hurt to specify the platform like that, like platform 64, ARM64, all right? So basically you're getting a default tag and it's basically just downloading the image from the Docker. So that's how it is, guys. It works fine, but you need to remind yourself. And another good thing is that we finally got Docker like stable release on Mac, so you can actually also run the Docker directly on your Mac. So it's all good. Finally, I mean, it took a while actually to get like stable working version of the Docker. I also had a question, guys, how to exchange data between your host and guest, and basically the guest is the Parallels instance, in this case is a Kali Linux, and host is my Mac OS. So how to basically exchange data? And by default, if you go here to the network, as you can see it says shared network recommended, and basically it means that IP is shared and all the data is shared right here. So you can basically just type this IP address, so you just type this address on your host and it exchanges data just fine. So for example, right now I have a Docker image running right here. Okay, I need to remind myself to type administrative password all the time. So if you see the process right here, you can see the on cloud process running, and as you can see it's running on my host machine just fine, so no problem. You can even set it up to exchange the clipboard, by the way. You just need to remind yourself to install the Parallels tools on your machine, and in my case it was installed automatically because it's a Kali Linux, it's specifically created for the Parallels. Everything except the sound is super great. I mean, I really like it. Guys, it also shares the hard drive, so you can just like set it up in Parallels wherever you want. For example, this Mac Compat, I was able to basically connect it right here on the guest. So it's all fine, it's all good. No need to set it up anything, it just like works almost automatically, all good in that kind of sense. And this is actually like really, really good comparing to UTM. UTM is just a mess. There is not much solutions, guys, for the Mac in terms of virtualization right now. I actually have a video about that, but there's just like a commercial product we have, the Parallels, and free solution is UTM and a few others which also like don't work really well, just like all experimental, all buggy, all crashing like crazy. Yeah, by the way guys, you know what my favorite utility here? My favorite utility is Dmitri. This is just like my favorite utility. Anyway, I'm just kidding. Just pulling your leg, guys. Anyway guys, thank you for watching. Please subscribe to my channel, there'll be more videos. And by the way, I know you like my accent because many people are commenting like how awesome is my accent is, so I'm just gonna continue pushing that accent. Sorry, I mean, I cannot do anything with myself, that's how it is. I plan to do more like automation kind of tutorials about WebDriver testing. Also, I'm thinking more about React Native kind of testing because I'm learning myself and I just want to share that knowledge with you guys. I think this is the future. I mean, unfortunately, hybrid apps and applications running like basically WebView kind of stuff, it seems like it's the future, unfortunately, because it speeds up the development of the applications. But what we can do, and that's how it is, guys. Anyway, guys, thank you for watching and please subscribe. Thank you.